warning, scary act.
I don't like it.
Between the dark and the light, the good and the evil, which will you choose?
Oh dear.
Oh no, is it coming out? I don't like it.
Don't come down here.
Careful, Simon.
Oh, there are two pathways for you, David.
Yes.
Which do you choose? Take an apple. Take a bite.
Mmm. It's nice.
Mmm. Your turn, Alicia. Between the good and the evil, which will you choose? Take an apple. Bitey bite. Something I've got to tell you, but it can wait. It can wait. Amanda, stand up.
Oh gosh, it's always me.
Put your hands out, face up. Come closer, come closer. There we are. Your destiny will be chosen by another.
Oh God.
Between the dark and the light. Only choose left or right. Louder!
Right.
Who's right though?
My right. Take a bite. Amanda.
Yeah.
You know why they say that beauty's only skin deep? We're all rotten to the core.
Okay, well, that was horrific.
And
the witch has turned into a cockroach. So we're gonna have to talk to them.
I mean, I was scared to death. I mean, I'd quite like to see what else was gonna happen.
I'm with you.
In the future.
Alicia, what do you think?
I thought the act was actually brilliant.
David.
I thought it was stunning. So I think we should vote, and let me kick this off with a yes!
I'm saying yes!
Amanda.
It's a yes from me.
We want to see you in the next round. I don't know how you did that. Maybe we'll see you in the finals. Congratulations.
It's freaking me out.
Did I come back? He and she?
I don't know.
What was that?
Did you see that?
Look weird, isn't it?
Welcome. What's your name, please?
It's Elizabeth.
Elizabeth?
Just Elizabeth.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
because I want to show you something special and try and make the impossible possible.
Well, the stage is yours, Elizabeth.
Theatres of London's West End, it's said to be haunted by many ghosts. In 1919, the great Harry Houdini appeared on stage and offered a large cash sum for anyone who could prove the existence of them. Amanda, I'd like you to take this journal in your left hand, and I'd like you to come with me.
I'm scared.
Legends have said that spirits departed walk the halls and stores of the theatres of London. It is said to be good luck to see ghosts for a performer. For others, not so much.
You look scared.
That's under the stage.
Amanda, please take a seat. These photographs are of people who have lived and died over 100 years ago.
I'm kind of creeped out.
Can you hold out your left hand like this? Now, in a moment, I want you to count these photographs face down onto the table, one at a time. When you place them down, you're going to feel a connection to one. When you feel that connection, I want you to stop and to place that photograph face down into this cigar box. Look at the photographs. Each and every one is different, but you were drawn to one and you don't know why.
No.
Open the cigar box and take out the photograph that you chose. Turn it over and read out what it says.
Agatha Turner, 1860.
Before this all began, I gave you a journal that's over 100 years old. Open the page I've bookmarked and read out the paragraph that I've circled in red.
Miss Turner was born in the 1800s. She loved visiting the West End to be entertained. She tragically died in 1860, and her ghost is said to haunt the theatres that she once loved.
Amanda, this moment was always meant to be. Look over your left shoulder.
Oh my God!
Do that.
is going to start crying.
You can't see me. You will never see me. I'm invisible, but I'm here. All over here, right now. I'm standing right in front of one of the judges.
No. What? Did you touch that?
No, I didn't touch it. I don't know what's going on.
Amanda, please follow me up onto the stage.
I always do.
Come and take a seat.
I don't like it.
I'm just going to grab something from over here. Oh. Amanda, please hold the balloon by the stick. Balloons are the first thing that we all learn to lose. Like the child that lost this balloon earlier today. They thought it was a gust of wind. It wasn't. It was me. I stole it to teach a lesson. Loss. You might think it was rather mean to burst a balloon like that, but losing things is an important part of life. I'll show you what I mean. Amanda, the box on this trolley is the theater's lost property box. Please open the lid. Without showing anyone, Amanda, you will take one of the items and place it under the cloth on the trolley. Being invisible means I can't have material possessions of my own. So, instead, I just steal them from other people. And better yet, I can compel other people to do my bidding. Alicia, reach in with your right hand. Take a random object and hold it so no one can see what you chose. You are holding a secret in your hands. One that nobody could possibly know. Remember, you could have taken anything from that box, and yet, Amanda knows exactly what you have taken.
Sure.
Dummy.
No way.
This is weird.
But there's just one object left to identify. The one that you took at the beginning, Amanda. There is a piece of chalk on the trolley. Please pick it up and bring it to me over here. I'm standing in front of the blackboard. And let go of it, Amanda. I will take it from here.
How is it doing that?
Amanda, please lift the cloth. Show everyone what you put there. Please keep hold of those keys and take them back to your seat. You see, I've been amongst you these last few days. It's just that no one ever saw me. Those keys that you randomly chose belong to David.
What?
And David, please look after them, because next time, I won't be so kind. Goodbye, until I see you all again.
And take what's inside.
I'm not talking.
Choices made, destiny or chance. But which will you choose? You'll have nightmares and fears, and I feel them all. So many nightmares, so many fears. You. What is your fear? Reach inside, pray tell.
Do I read it out?
Pray tell.
Oh. My fear is David Hasselhoff returning to the show. No. Sorry, it's tapeworm.
Tapeworm.
I'm scared of a tapeworm.
Fate has brought us to a place in your soul that no one could know. Or could they? You. What is your fear?
You right now. Oh, you want me to pick one? Oh, I don't really want to go for one. I don't really want to touch it.
Reforming Mystique.
Earring? What? Earring?
Earwig.
Oh, earwig.
Earwig. Earring, earwig.
Did look like earring, sorry.
Another fear to remember this moment, but. Ah. The cowl. Such a strong name. That you stink of fear.
Well, by the way, if I may so, you don't smell great yourself. At least I use soap.
What am I supposed to do now?
Read it.
Well, I know that, and do what?
Just tell him.
Losing the phone number of my plastic surgeon.
David has just signed a 10-year contract. No, maggots.
Oh, God.
How pathetic.
Well, I didn't write it.
But you chose it. Well, my pretty, here is where it all ends, because tonight is all about you, your fear, your choice. Pray tell.
Oh, God.
What's that?
Rodent.
Oh, no!
Look into the future.
Oh.
Reach inside the box,
no,
take the manuscript, and I'll prove to you what I knew all along. Reach inside. Reach inside!
Reach inside!
Is there a rat in there?
I feel sorry for her.
We met, it was proven that Amanda was connected to Agatha. Agatha has not been seen since that time. However, Amanda, I can see that Agatha is with you now, and I'm going to prove it to you. Simon and Amanda, can you turn your chairs and face each other? Amanda, I want you to close your eyes now, and whatever happens, do not open them until I tell you to.
Okay.
Are they closed?
Yes.
Amanda, did you feel something?
Yes.
Because Agatha is standing right beside you now.
Oh, God, no, don't.
What exactly did you feel?
I felt somebody scratch my nose.
Open your eyes, Amanda. Oh. You need to come with me.
Oh, no.
All right. Good luck with everything.
God. Amanda, I've been researching Agatha these last months. And I've learnt that her daughter was just 11 years old when she was cruelly taken away from her. I want to show you now something that was special to her daughter.
I'm so glad I wore a double gusset.
This songbook used to belong to Agatha's daughter. These songs are over 100 years old. Amanda, I want you to open the book like this at any page. I want you to remember that song. It's important that you do. Come with me. Amanda, the year is 1809. Agatha's daughter Florence was just 11 years of age.
God.
Oh my God! Please take a seat. Amanda, you're thinking of a song. I want you to hum that song now over and over in your mind.
Goodbye, baby, on the treetop. When the wind blows the
Amanda, look at the box on your right.
When the bell breaks,
can you open the box? Open the box and take out what's inside.
Come, baby, cradle.
Open up the letter and read it out loud.
Dearest Amanda, I've been with you longer than you realise. Since we first met, I've never left your side. On this day, my daughter Florence was cruelly taken from me, and I've spent several lifetimes searching for her. God.
To you is because someone very close to you is connected to her daughter. He just doesn't realize it yet.
I actually did have a ghost once in one of my houses. So I do believe in them.
Simon, the night is still not over. I've been Elizabeth. And this is The Haunting. Thank you.
What have I got to do?
Hello. You can't see me.
You'll never see me, but I am back. Judges, I'm coming to see you. Shall we toast my return? David, please think of a memory from your childhood. Is a pen and paper. Please write down that memory from your childhood in just a few words. Amanda, look away. That's better. Keep looking away, Amanda. Now, David, think of the exact hour and minute when that memory happened. Go with your instincts. Write that hour and minute on a piece of paper. It is important that you lock that time into your memory. Now fold up the paper and hold it in your hand. Don't let go. Amanda, can you confirm you have no idea what is about to happen?
No, I've got no clue.
Then Amanda, follow me onto the stage. Let's head over to my work desk. Come along quickly, Amanda. Time is of the essence. Quickly, Amanda. Quickly, watch your step. Come along. They say that X marks the spot. Stand on the X beside the red chair. To your left. Stand on the X. Let me just move these papers. This blueprint is of something that I've built. Let's keep it away from prying eyes for now, though. Amanda, behind you is something I've been working on since we last met. Walk over to the machine. Yes. It will enable you to join me in my invisible world. Quickly, round the back. Now please step inside. The crew will help you. Yes. The crew will help you. And don't be scared. Your powers is to now pass through solid walls. Take my hand. You are now completely invisible, just like me. Let's walk over to my desk. Now, take a seat. Focus your energy on the candle. Now look over at the judges. You can see them, but they can't see you. Simon, silently think of a number from 1 to 10. Hold up that number of fingers now. And David, please come up onto the stage with your piece of paper. Join us at the table and sit on the red chair. Amanda, please tell Simon how many fingers he is holding up.
Simon, you're holding up 7 fingers.
Welcome, Simon. Amanda, open the lost property box. David, place the piece of paper into the box beside the note that I have written to. Amanda, close the lid. David, think of your memory. Think of the exact time in hours and minutes that you wrote down. Focus on it clearly and tell us Exactly what time was it?
Do I say it now?
Yes, tell us.
Sorry. 12:15 p.m.
Now, David, you can see an object covered with a red cloth here at the end of my work desk. It has been sitting here this entire time, and nobody has been near it. Yet some don't believe me, so Amanda, pull the cloth away and show us.
12:15.
David, stand up. Stand up, David.
Sorry.
And walk to the side of the stage.
The side or
the other side, David?
What, sorry, this one. Sorry.
Left, David, turn left. David, you're on the left. Behind you, David. I'm over here, David. I'm over here.
This side.
Yes.
I can't hear him very well. Sorry. I can't hear him. I can't hear. Sorry.
David, you'll see a mirror over there. Stand on the X and face the mirror. Now, look to your left, because Amanda is standing next to you. Stand on the X, David, and look in the mirror. Amanda, David is thinking of a memory. What is it?
I can see water. I can see an accident. I think David's in maybe like a girl guide outfit. Oh no, no, it's like a cub. Do you still have the cubs? It's like the cubs. I think David fell into some water. David fell into a river, dressed up as a cub.
My work desk on stage. And Amanda, please open the box. David, inside the box are two pieces of paper. Take them both with you and return to the judge's desk. One of those pieces of paper is going to be important in a moment, David. Thank you, Amanda. You can close the box again.
I couldn't hear him. I just couldn't.
Now, Amanda, the time has come. You have briefly visited me in my invisible world. The time is coming. I need you to breathe in, Amanda, and focus on yourself becoming the person that you once were. Amanda, the time has come for you to return to your reality and wake up! Return to the judge's desk. And David, take a deep breath. Return to your seat, Amanda. Thank you for joining me in my invisible world. David, you were holding a message from me. Please read it out loud.
David, you can't see me, you'll never see me, but I am always right here.
Until next time.